exactly how I like to do it.
3, 2, 1.
Say zero, dude.
Zero.
Welcome to TigerBelly. Welcome to TigerBelly. My name is Bob. We've got Khalyla, Gilbert, Georgetown University, George, and Pink Dick. And I'm going to say this right now. I apologize for my behavior when I came in. Number one, I'm sick. Mm. Number two, I had to carry 4 gigantic bags and then a litter that, like, my arms are like completely tore up.
You could have texted one of us.
I understand that, but I want to do it myself because I'm a man. Mm-hmm. And number three, is that three yet?
Three, yeah.
I'm going to go to 2.
Okay.
I'm going to make it 2. Okay. And number two, right? I came in here and I said, hey, can you help me put the stuff away because the cat food and all the treats that I bought, Googie and everyone, they get into it. So I wanted to hide all that stuff. Mm-hmm. And I came in and I think that's my bad. I apologized. And I want everyone to forgive me now. I apologize. I don't feel well.
I've forgiven you.
Okay.
You know, strangely enough,
yeah.
You wouldn't strike me normally as a guy who is like who's gentleman-like.
Yeah.
Normally, right? From afar or from what people hear, you would probably assume that Bobby is somebody who lets everybody do everything for him.
Mm-hmm.
But he will never let me carry a grocery bag, never let me carry my own luggage. He really is a man in that way.
God, how nice.
Wow. She's
he always, I mean, even when he's struggling.
Fantastic.
Keep going, Claire.
Even when he's struggling and I offer and he's pissed, he's pissed at the weight he has to carry,
mm-hmm.
he insists on carrying it.
Because I still want to be a man.
As a gentleman.
And I apologize, and I want to start off with the show in a different way tonight.
Mm-hmm.
And I want to start off with the show with some fun facts.
Okay. Mm-hmm.
If you don't mind.
Yeah.
And I have 2 fun facts, and I would like you to let me finish the fun facts before you interrupt me, anybody in the room.
Mm-hmm.
Can you do that
for me? We can, yes.
Thank you so much. I read this the other day that you remember what happened in Japan, the Hiroshima and Nagasaki, the bombing, the atomic bombs.
Yes, of course.
Okay, well, in Nagasaki, there was a sound engineer. I don't know if you guys know this or not. Mm. And he recorded the bomb going off from Ground Zero.
Wow.
And there isn't a sound in this earth that even competes with that sound or similar. The only thing that's similar is Khalyla's fart from the other day.
Damn, that was a good reversal.
Yeah, thank you.
I was not expecting
her fart from the other day.
Unintentional.
The cats and I were under this desk. I mean, I literally thought, what the fuck was that?
Well,
was that a quee fart? I mean, was it together?
No, it was one of those. Like,
you said you don't fart.
It's a pee fart. When you're peeing, I thought that he was. I left the door open, and I really wasn't expecting so much to come out, to be honest, with such, you know, oomph.
Pee fart?
No, while I'm peeing, you know, I was pushing the pee out, and like unexpectedly.
I literally almost broke up with her.
Magnitude 8.1, guys.
It's a breakup.
It was like a breakup fart for sure. Within. Yeah, and it echoed too because I farted into the toilet reverberated in the toilet walls.
Yeah, that fucked me up, guys.
Yeah.
I have another fun fact if you want to hear it.
Yes, oh, God. Yes, please. More fun facts. I love fun facts.
You guys like fun facts?
TigerBelly, fun facts.
Fun facts.
Yeah, here we go.
I have another fun fact. Did you guys know
that
Enya wrote the song Return to Innocence? Mm-hmm. Even though if you Googled it online or if you asked Enya herself, did you write the song Return of Innocence or record it or even do a cover it? And she'll say no. But you know what? That's a fact. You know why that's a fact? Because fucking Khalyla in the car the other day goes, you know what? Because I was playing Enya on my car.
Mm-hmm. He was playing Orinoco Flow.
Orinoco Flow, the song. Mm-hmm. She goes, oh, that's a good song. I go, yeah, that's their number one song. No, she goes, Return of Innocence is their number one song.
Return to Innocence.
Whatever it is. And I go, never heard of that song. I'm a huge Enya fan. I have all that shit, even the Lord of the Rings shit.
Mm-hmm.
I've never heard of it. So I Googled it, mm-hmm. couldn't find it. You go to fucking iTunes. It's not even in her top 100 songs. And she argued for like 20 fucking minutes in the car. And she's adamant. You're fucking wrong. Bobby, you're retarded. And all that shit. And guess what? Enigma wrote it.
It's Enigma. The
you
German
just checked
group.
It? Yeah. But then
I couldn't fucking believe it.
So I got, we got to the point where I was actually able to convince him that this was an Enya song that was only released in the Philippines and Australia.
Yeah.
You went to those depths.
I mean, you guys, yeah. I went through a length.
You knew you were wrong.
No, I didn't know I was wrong at this point. But I was able to convince him, and he goes, "Huh, you might be right." No. So I was, but I was still so. I really wanted to. Like for him to listen to the song, so I Googled or I put it on YouTube, and as soon as I saw Enigma instead of Enya, I was like, "Oh dear God, do I let this conversation die now that I've actually won the discussion, or do I tell the truth?"
What did you do?
I looked over. We were driving to Brea, and I looked over and I said, "I made a mistake."
And we both laughed.
We laughed so hard for 30 minutes.
For 30 minutes.
I conceded. I mean, I waved my white flag. It was my bad, and I had a really righteous moment, and I was wrong, and I'm sorry.
So that happened.
I have another fun fact.
Go ahead. Okay, you have fun facts? Say your fun facts.
Well, just because I was able to see your missing tooth from this angle, yeah. Bobby has about 9 missing teeth.
Okay, that's a fact. Fun fact. I don't want anyone to fucking know. I mean, you want to go into fun facts? You want to really get into fun facts? All right.
He has to full swallow carne asada because he can't chew it.
Her friend Jessica wears a scarf because she has a gigantic cyst on her fucking neck.
What is Jessica? It's not even a koala's fun fact. Poor Jessica.
What?
That's her friend. Yeah, she has an epidermal cyst.
Yeah. I thought that was a fashion thing.
She was wearing a scarf for the last 2 weeks, and I figured
it out. She's going to kill you.
I don't give a fuck.
Well, we tweeted Dr. Pimple.
If you want to do fun facts, we'll do fun facts. If you don't want to do fun facts, we don't have to do fun facts. Do you understand me?
Fun facts.
Now listen to this, okay? I also want to say, Brea, I played there. The best crowds ever.
Best.
I really believe that it was TigerBelly that pulled me through. Mm. The ticket sales were amazing. The people were amazing. And I had a really good time. In fact, that was a very good birthday week for myself. So many things happened. Number one, I turned old, 45. Number two, I did get sick. I'm really sick right now. But, you know, the new Iron
DLC
came out. Mm-hmm. So much fun.
Right in time
for your
birthday.
They took me to dinner last night.
We all took you to dinner.
Great. Thank you. Mm-hmm. What was my gift from you, Gilbert?
My gift is here.
No, that fuck you.
Hey, I get paid next week. I get paid next week.
I understand that, but you don't show up to people's birthday parties without a fucking gift, man.
He helped pay for the meal.
Really?
Yes, he did.
There's no fucking way.
A small portion.
Yeah, how much? A small portion of it.
I want to know how much.
He paid the tip.
I put like $40.
Yeah, he did.
Okay.
You did?
Mm-hmm.
Yeah. Oh, that's nice.
And I need that money back.
Do you really need the money back?
I don't need the money back.
I'm gonna get you. I'll Venmo you.
No, I don't need the money back.
I'll Venmo you the money. And then last night, then we watched a movie last night. We saw
Blair Witch.
The Blair Witch.
Were you guys scared?
You know what? I was. I'm scared of everything though. So
I've never seen. I kind of just say this before you even get into it. Is that Khalyla screamed
in the movie theater?
No, she screamed the most at.
That's not true.
I just want to say.
That's not true.
Fun facts.
This is a fun fact.
Oh, right? I also screamed during appropriate scary moments. The theater was completely quiet, you guys, and all you hear was.
And who did that?
It was you.
All right.
Wait.
The
okay.
Wrong time.
Why was there a ghost there?
There was no ghost. There was no ghost. No, nothing scary. He just freaked out over.
I just freaked out over nothing. Yeah. But you know what she did?
What?
She saw a white dude with a little mud on his face, and she screamed like as if that was the Blair Witch itself.
I did.
Why? Yeah.
She went. And everyone's looking at her like, what the fuck is a white dude?
Was it even a shock?
He came out of nowhere. There was a little bit. He came around the corner and he had mud on his face and I freaked out.
Yeah.
It's great.
That movie was not good, but it was scary at times.
Oh, but isn't that the point of a scary movie? I can only base it on how scared
out of all the realism, I know that scary movies aren't realistic and they're not grounded in any kind of truth, maybe there are, you know what I mean? But there's just certain things I just couldn't get over. And the beginning is, and I'm going to say something, and I don't want anyone listening to think that I'm a racist, because I'm not. And I'm also going to ask a question, right? So it's just a question, but do black people go camping?
Yes.
Who?
I will say I've been camping twice in my life.
Never.
I never went with the black
person. Never even seen a photo of it.
Mostly white people.
And I'm sure there's five in the world.
Yeah.
Okay. I'm sure there's one Asian guy who's a NASCAR driver. We don't know his name.
No.
Because he loses every fucking
last place,
right? But that in itself, two black people camping, it just threw me out.
Yeah.
The whole movie, you saw that?
Also, there was a point where this black guy and his girlfriend, who happens to be African-American also, they cross a river. She steps on something. She's obviously, she's in a lot of pain. It's bleeding. It's terrible. At that point, this is what I would do. Hey, guys. Well, first of all, I would never even go into the forest. You know what? The premise in itself is some dude's sister was in the original Blair Witch, and he wants to go look for her like 20 years later.
Oh, that's for the sequel.
Yeah. All right. Ask me to come with you.
Hey, you want to go find my sister?
Where?
In the forest?
Nope.
But it's just...
I'd rather stick an M80 in my butthole and light it on fire.
Bobby, that's...
I don't care. Your sister's dead, dude.
Whoa, what the fuck?
She's dead. It's 20 years.
Yeah, she's dead.
That's it. That's the conversation. Okay? So this black guy goes, I'll go with my black girlfriend. They cross a river. She gets hurt. And all of a sudden, he doesn't turn around and go, we got to go to the hospital? That's what I would do.
Right.
And that was like early on in the movie?
I have personal experience with something like that.
With what? Me?
No. I went camping.
Okay, good.
And I had my skateboard with me, and I bombed this hill, and I got into a really, really bad accident to where my nipple was basically, my left nipple was basically
First of all, you don't bring a skateboard into the mountains.
No. It wasn't. There was a little, cave that area in, Santa Onofre.
Terrain, heavy terrain.
It's like I went swimming with my football helmet
on. It wasn't, deep into the fucking woods, is what I'm saying. Oh, I see. It wasn't deep. There were still some little, streets here and there. It was, a California campsite.
Yeah.
And I had road rash from my chin all the way down to my ankles. Your pussy. I mean, honestly, yeah. I actually had road rash in my pussy, my nipple,
inside
everything.
The pussy?
My hands were all everywhere. Okay. I had gravel all over my body.
And what'd you do?
And I stayed there. That was the first day. The first day I got into an accident, and I stayed there the whole weekend instead of going home.
Okay. Who were you dating at the time?
Nobody.
Okay.
You're alone?
Because...
Were you with...
With Jessica, my sister.
Okay.
And the only reason that I stayed is because I didn't want to ruin everyone else's weekend. I had guilt about it. I don't want people to feel sorry for me.
Yeah, but that's one thing. It's but it's still not you gouging your foot where it's obviously infected.
Hospital.
Yeah,
hospital.
We need to go to the hospital.
Well, also, they were in the thick of the Maryland forest that looks scary and
yeah,
very,
but
very...
Here's the thing. The reason why they all died, and if you haven't seen the movie, I'm sorry.
It's Blair Witch.
Right, but the reason why, and they explain it in the movie, is that you have to spend the night.
Yeah.
And that they hadn't spent the night at the time. So if I was the black dude, we wouldn't have been dead because we would have been in the hospital, which is something that you're supposed to do.
Yeah.
Anyway. But that was that. It was fun, though, I guess.
Breathe In better than that?
Oh, Don't Breathe is
Don't Breathe
a
way
great
more, yeah,
movie.
Yeah.
So choose that one.
Very
guys.
Good.
Yeah. Don't Breathe is way better. But still fun to watch.
I still thought it was very scary, but I'm also not a good critic of scary movies because my standard is so low. Everything scares me. Yeah, the music scares me.
A white guy with mud.
Yeah, everything.
Yeah. It was amazing.
You know, I'm sure other people in that theater were like, who the fuck cares? That wasn't scary at all. But I screamed.
And I want to also propose a question real quick, and I don't want to start a fight or anything. And I want you, baby, I don't want you to get angry with me. I'm sick. I don't feel great.
Okay.
Is this last night I was playing the new DLC with my brother and some friends.
Yeah.
And my brother's girlfriend goes, okay, that's enough. And he got off.
Wow.
Because she probably drove an hour to go see your brother and spend some time with him because she doesn't
regardless see him every day. Of what the reason is, that's not going to keep him.
Keep him.
That in itself, that kind of behavior is going to make him go, fuck this.
I think your brother's girlfriend is
she's amazing.
A doll.
Super nice.
I think that she's smart.
Yeah.
I think that she's full of character. I think that she's so easy to be around.
I understand that. I love her.
Exactly. So
that's not what I'm saying. What I'm saying is that, you know, the DLC just dropped. Let the dude play.
Did he rage out after that?
No, he was just like, okay. And he just kind of disappeared.
But they don't see each other every day like you and I. And she drives an hour to see him. So yeah, if I go drive an hour to see a dude and he just plops on his couch and plays video games the whole night, no, I'm out.
Can I just say that I'm going to do a reverse.
I need to get some dick. If I go drive an hour and I'm out.
Okay, can I just say
devil's
this?
Advocate?
Can I just say this?
Yeah.
Okay. Is if, let's say you were, Khalyla, you love hula hooping. Okay. You're addicted to it. You love hula hooping. You grew up with it.
We've talked
you
about
watch
this
the videos, right?
Yeah.
And one day, you waited a year for this new hula hoop to happen. Yeah. Mm-hmm. Right? It's like light. You know what I mean? It's got tech.
Yeah.
You know what I mean?
More circular.
Yeah, circular. Yeah. You know what I mean? And you just couldn't wait. You Googled. You read about it. And it drops. And you said, you know what, Bobby? I'm going to be on this hula hoop for 3 days. I'll be like, go get it. Mm-hmm. Go do it. Because I know that you're happy when you do it. And I want to make you happy.
Yeah, but also, can I say something?
And even if you lived Alaska and I flew up there.
Yeah.
Hula hoop your fucking ass
but
up.
But that's the point. If I tell you, hey, Bobby, I'm going to hula hoop for 3 days.
Yeah.
How about you don't drive from LA to Long
Beach? No, I want to see you.
Nope.
Yeah. Well, I'm just telling you how I am. Because I love you so much.
Oh, bullshit.
Just shut the fuck up. I will go. You know what? You go to a different house. I just want to be even in your vicinity. Mm. I want your happiness to radiate through the walls.
Wow.
To like go into my fucking soul. And I want to see your face light up because you're so fucking happy. And you could do it for a year, every day for a year. And if I didn't see you for every day for a year, I would be bummed because I haven't seen you. But you know what? As long as you're happy, I'm happy.
Bullshit.
And that's not what you did.
I don't think it is right for us to ever discuss anything relationship-wise with your brother. That's his private life, and you should never...
Oh, I just asked you a question.
He's going to be upset that we even talked about this. Who cares? That's none of your business what they do together or how they deal with
it
things.
It affects me, though.
It doesn't affect you.
I'll tell you what it affects me.
The only reason it affects you is because he's been your toy your whole life, and now your playmate is playing with somebody else, and you're jealous.
No, that's not what it... Whoa, now it's getting good. Now it's turning into Ricky Lake. I love it. It's turning into Ricky Lake. No, I'm bummed because I'm standing in a fucking... with aliens surrounding me on the Cosmodrome, right? Steve?
Yeah, Bob?
No, you're not there.
Oh, bye, Bob.
You're sleep cuddling with a girl that you're like in bummed and angry.
Yeah.
Oh, no. That's what... he abandoned his brother.
Yeah.
In war. That's why I'm mad. Mm. Okay?
Brothers in arms, I see.
And Steve... if he's not gonna know
he's
about
not gonna
it.
Listen to this, but people always write some shit and they always make him aware that we had a discussion, and it's not fair to him.
Well, I
you
want
know?
Him to know that.
Well, also
through a podcast form.
Yeah.
Second you're hand. Gonna fucking cause some drama and a fight with him. Watch.
I won't. Trust me, I won't. Nah, I won't.
That's his relationship. Let him handle it as
not.
He sees fit. You
I will
know?
Not. You know, she's cool. I want it to work. Okay, but.
She likes the Red House Painters. How much cooler can she be for
it.
You? That's like your favorite band. And she actually knows their songs.
I'm just telling her, if she's listening, that's not the way into his heart. That's all I'm saying. Mm-hmm. Okay? And I apologize. I
he's sick.
I'm sick. I'm confrontational. And I say things. Maybe black people do camp. You know, I just ask questions. Okay? The only thing.
Go ahead,
baby.
Bobby and I always try. I need a lot of reassurance sometimes. And last week I asked him, hey, like, if I got really, really fat, would you stay with me? He's like, yeah, as a matter of fact, I want you to gain 40 pounds. I'm like, okay, what if I lost like one of my limbs? Would you stay with me? He's like, yeah, of course, sweetie. I love you, blah, blah, blah. So I was like, what if like 60% of my body, mostly my face, was burned? He goes, of course. So I show him a picture. Did I not show you a picture?
Mm-hmm.
Of a woman, a burn victim who recently got engaged to her husband.
Mm-hmm.
And what do you think he said? I asked him, would you stay with me if I look like this?
No.
I would. She just has to wear a mask. And that's not.
You're still with her.
I'm still with her.
You're loyal.
Yeah.
Just put on a mask.
Yeah. Wear, you know, one of those Halloween, Mike Myers, yeah, Halloween, yeah. Like hockey mask. Mm-hmm. Or you can change it up every day, do a different mask. Mm-hmm. I'm Nixon all of a sudden, you know?
You're okay with that.
Yeah, I'm okay with it. But I don't want, because what happens then is this, okay?
keep going.
Is that then you have to kind of, when you work to dinner, mm-hmm. and then like I run into a friend, then you have to
explain
what happened. To the
but
face.
You don't have to explain the mask.
Oh, because it's like, I met her before that.
Yeah. What? She's like, artsy in that way. Or whatever, you know?
She's Silver Lake.
Yeah. But yeah, I mean, no, I don't know. I don't know what that's like. Maybe I will, maybe I won't. You don't think that I would?
What about you, Khalyla? Bobby gets his arm burned. His whole arm burned.
He already looks like a burn victim to me.
Okay, he loses an eye.
Of course.
Yeah,
of
but
course.
If I lost an eye and if I was in a fire, I wouldn't want to live. Mm. I mean, I'm depressed as it is, and this is a sad thing to say, and I want to be. I'm going to say something. If I couldn't walk or I couldn't feel my dick from a car accident, I really don't know if I would stick around. If I went blind, I don't know. I might just kill myself.
No.
No, just listen. I don't know. I'm asking the universe, would I not? I don't know. But my opinion now would be maybe I would.
You know, it's funny that you say that, and I think maybe I've mentioned it in a previous episode, but when my grandfather always used to say the same thing. He always used to say, I don't want to live past 60. I don't want to live past 60 because it's like, what kind of quality of life am I going to have after that?
Mm-hmm.
This was like 25 years ago or 20 years ago or something. And I always used to remember this. And when he was 59, he got diagnosed with lung cancer and only had 6 months to live.
Yeah.
So on his 60th birthday, we had like a little back house for him. My dad set up a little hospital setting with his oxygen and, you know, his bed and everything. And he was speaking with my dad and mom, and he was just shattered, talking about why God would take his life so soon. I want to live. I still want to live. He tried to fight his diagnosis. He really, really could not accept that he was going to die. And he died at the age of 60.
Yeah, but that's different. I'm not saying that if I want to live forever.
No, what I'm saying is,
but he wasn't in a fire.
No, listen. What I'm saying is he didn't want to live past 60 ever because he just didn't think like the quality of life. He just didn't want to be an old guy. He never wanted to be an old guy.
I mean, I felt the same way for years, but then I watched Olders for Youngers.
changed my life.
But, you're fine.
Yeah. But what I'm saying is that, okay, so what you're saying to me is that he changed his tune and he wanted to live.
He absolutely wanted to live.
Okay, if I was in a fire, maybe, see, that's the thing. I don't know. I've never been in a fire.
I think that my dad was very similar too. I mean, the last year of his life, he had a gangrenous foot, you know, and he was in a lot of pain, and he was already in his 79, and you would think that, yeah, put me out of my fucking misery. And he coded probably 6 times that year, meaning to say they had to like resuscitate him and bring him back to life. But he kept telling the hospital, you know, if I flatline, I want to be resuscitated each time.
Oh,
he was in a DNR. DNRs do not resuscitate. And in your papers or in the hospital, if you're admitted, they always know when you do not want to be resuscitated, they'll let you die. But my dad kept wanting to live. And I mean, he was no longer mobile. He was in a fucking, he was shitting himself. He was completely incontinent. He had a foot that was charcoal black. But it was enough for him to just see his daughters and even little things like eat lunch with him by his bedside while he was getting fed, you know, like not real food anymore. But it was enough for him. So people do want to, you don't know how you're going to feel until you're there.
You're right. Yeah, I don't know.
Yeah.
But also I might be similar. I think if I'm in a vegetative state, like I probably, and if my mind, you know, like lock-in syndrome where your mind is fully intact, but your body is completely like vegetative, I would want to be put out for sure.
Deanna. Okay, well then you have your thing.
Yeah. But not over a fucking eye.
Okay, one eye.
No, I wouldn't. I want to live after one eye.
One eye's fine.
Two eyes,
no.
Two eyes, I probably would.
Even one eye, one ear.
I'd learn.
I would be able to do it.
I'd learn like, you know, just
like yeah. And just walk around like, you know what I mean? Hey, in a circle.
You just have to learn like echolocation, like the dolphins. Like,
yeah.
But if I was in a fire, you know what I would do? I would live in a forest and want to be like the Bobby Witch, like the Blair Witch, right? And have like folklore.
You're the urban myth.
Right, I'm the urban myth.
Oh, shit.
And I would do kind of crazy shit.
Such as?
When white people are camping, I just do kind of things. When they're sleeping, maybe I'll inject them. I'll find some sort of like ointment out there that'll make them pass out.
Okay.
You know what's really we watched.
You're not gonna let me finish the.
No, go ahead. Go ahead. Okay. Wait. Can we pause real quick?
Yeah.
Can you put that dog in her crate?
You put it in the crate, Georgie.
Because she's gonna keep barking the rest of the time.
Okay. So you take the ointment. You inject it in white people.
I don't know what you would get.
What happens after they fall asleep because they're already asleep?
What?
They're
I would do stuff like just they'll all the tents, all their clothes, everything's just gone.
So they're just completely naked. So they wake up naked, no.
They're naked, on right?
Oh, okay, that won't.
Right.
Okay.
And I digged a ditch, right? And then, but their heads are on the above the ground.
Shit, that's some scary stuff.
Right.
Yeah.
I wouldn't kill them. Right. And I would have like some sort of what animals live out like
there's deer, wolves,
coyote poop, and it's smeared all over their faces, right? And then I would probably make these little Bobby Lee statues out of wood, and they'd be on top of the coyote poop. They have a little poop, right? And they would just know that the Bobby Witch got them.
Holy shit! That guy from Love.
And then nobody would ever.
What the fuck?
Yeah, yeah. Did you do it, George?
Yep.
Thank you, George.
I think that is actually one of his like dreams. I mean fantasies. He would never do it in real life.
To be an urban legend?
No, yeah. To force inseminate people with his sperm, like with a turkey baster.
What?
Where did that come from?
wasn't what we were talking about?
No, we're not talking about that.
We literally went from injecting people to fall asleep with some ointment to
what?
I'm going to inject people with sperm?
You were talking about juice. That's where I thought, like, no, you like, were the Bobby Witch, like putting your jizz inside people.
So you're just impregnating people?
Yeah, but only guys in their buttholes.
Oh. Cream pie buttholes.
I want to cream pie buttholes.
But with turkey basters, yeah.
Because I think
this dog is going to drive me crazy, babe.
No, it's whatever. She's barking.
It's ambiance.
It's not ambiance. It's driving me fucking crazy.
Let's
now.
Pause until she's done barking.
I also was thinking about this. Gilbert, you don't know a lot of things. Mm-hmm. And there are things in the world where I think you should know. Mm-hmm. So every week, I'm just going to ask you a random question about something that I think you should know.
Okay.
And if you know it, I'm going to give you $50.
Okay.
It's a little contest.
Mm-hmm.
So every week I'm going to ask you something that I think that anyone that's in show business or a part of pop culture or anything should know. And if you know it, I'll give you $50. If you don't know it, I'm going to do 10 of these like things on your arms.
Okay.
Where I swack your arms.
Thwack.
Thwacks on the arms.
Thwacks.
Okay. You want to start this week?
Sure.
In the movie The Godfather, mm-hmm. movies. Mm-hmm. Who is the brother that portrayed Michael Corleone? What was the character's name?
I don't remember. I remember.
Fredo.
Okay.
Oh, Fredo.
You should know that.
I've seen the movie a long time ago.
You should know it.
Okay.
How about, this is an easier
one. I'm not going to twack you now because I'm sick.
Yeah.
But next week, I'm going to add it on to
it. Okay, that was the only one then. Yeah.
And more twacks.
Yeah. Every week, I'm going to ask you something that I think you should know.
Okay.
What's so funny, George? Did you know that?
Whoa, he's loud.
Hey,
oh.
Good news.
What?
There's somebody who actually lived out your true life fantasy.
True life fantasy.
Which one?
There's this doctor in Indiana mm-hmm. who, he's a fertility doctor, and he used his own sperm to impregnate a shit ton of women. They thought that they were being, inseminated by, a different sperm, and it turns out he was using his own sperm.
So it was a sperm bank.
No. He's a fertility doctor. He's the guy who actually performs.
So he takes
people's,
when a woman goes into his practice,
right.
They go, "This is the kind of sperm I want."
Sure.
White for sure, right?
Yeah, they have their
white,
pick. Yeah,
yeah, yeah. Sure. Smart
mm-hmm.
for sure.
Mm-hmm.
And then he just said, yeah, and he just injected his
own and his reasoning was, these women were just so desperate and they really wanted to get pregnant, and I knew for sure, like, my shit worked.
Yeah.
And I think that deep down, that's your fantasy to turkey-based people.
No. I'll tell you why. Because I don't want to do that, and then 20 years later, you know what I mean? I'm at a club, and I see a dude in the front row that kind of looks like me.
Well, that's what happened.
What happened?
Some girl wanted to track down her ancestry, and she was basically able to backtrack or like pin it onto him as being the father. And then she found out that she was genetically matched with like 12 other people. And she contacted one of them, and one of them was the real son of the doctor.
Oh, it's like a movie.
Yeah,
it's like a movie.
Mm-hmm.
And so, do you sue at that point?
Have to.
I mean, the women could. I don't know what the
are the grounds.
Oh God, it's like misleading. It's false. It's
unless the kid turned out to be like a fuck up.
Yeah.
Like the kid turned out to be a murderer. You know, yeah. He shot up a movie theater. Mm-hmm. Then you could sue. But if your kid is a good kid and went to college and, you know.
You could, sweetie, that's violation of my woman parts. You know, you're putting something into me. Like, I don't want your fucking sperm,
but
sir.
Baby, listen to me.
Yeah?
He gave you the sperm 20 years ago.
And I love my daughter.
You love your daughter.
That's right.
So without his sperm, that specific daughter would not be that. So unless the kid is horrifyingly bad,
yeah,
then you don't have no grounds.
Or also if he's still continuing to do this or to practice this.
If the kids are all pretty good kids, then keep it. Like, I'd rather have that doctor than Richard Kuklinski is your dad. The Iceman, you know, who murdered 80 people.
The mafia guy.
The mafia guy, right?
Yeah.
And you're like, oh, that's why I like to kill puppies with my hands.
Yeah.
You know, so it's like, it's better the doctor than that. Right? I'd rather have the doctor than this fucking guy's sperm. He doesn't know shit about nothing. Huh, Gilbert?
Yeah.
Gilbert knows shit
about nothing, dude.
Yeah, he does.
Man. I bet you he can't even fucking name me all the Beatles.
Yes, he can, sweetie.
Why would you put pressure on me like that? Not nervous.
Yeah, you can.
Okay. Paul.
With the whole first and
Ringo.
Last name, please. First
Paul
and,
McCartney.
Yes.
Ringo Starr.
Yes.
John Lennon.
Yes.
I got it. I'm trying to think of the last name. I think of the last name.
Baby,
that's
I
hard.
Swear to fucking God.
Really
I don't
hard.
Care, baby. You don't fuck around right now.
No, but last name. I don't know the last name. I'm trying to think of the last name.
That's it.
Ford.
You don't
blank
know.
Ford.
You don't know. Baby. That's it. Baby.
Ow! Stop that.
George Hare. George Hare?
That's it.
Almost.
You're done.
What was it, though?
George Harrison.
I said a blank Ford. Harrison Ford.
That's three out of four.
No, that is really bad.
That's not really bad.
Oh, yeah. It's the fucking Beatles, dude.
George Harrison's so forgettable.
Really?
I love George Harrison. Don't get me wrong. I love his song. I do like him. I'm just saying he's an easy one to forget.
He wrote Who Loves the Sun.
Yeah. Mm-hmm.
Okay. He wrote something, you know. I mean, he wrote a lot of the classics.
Dude, every other episode, you come here all righteous about, I know everything about the Beatles, and anyone who doesn't listen to White Album is trash. But it's like, okay, what the fuck else do you know? Can we step outside of
ask
the Beatles?
Ask me something then, bitch.
Three songs from the Platters.
'60s.
That's a well-known group.
Yeah.
Yeah. If you think.
Stop.
That's my grandparents play that.
You're now close to being a villain from a Batman movie. That voice. Okay. I'm gonna tell you this right now.
Yeah.
If you say rock and roll one more fucking
time.
I told you last week not to say fucking rock and roll.
He's been saying it every day.
And you've been saying it every fucking day now. You said it yesterday at fucking dinner, rock and roll. Right? And you're trying to do it to fucking get on my bad side. Okay? George, look at me right now. Don't ever say rock and roll again. I mean, you could say it in a sentence like, I like rock and roll, but not as a greeting or a statement. You know what I mean?
Yeah,
like, or
yeah,
something.
Yeah.
You know what I'm saying. Okay?
Yeah.
So what I'm saying to you is that the Platters is not even in the same dimension as the Beatles. And I don't want to talk about this anymore.
Whoa, a lot of influences for soul in the Platters. 60s. You know the songs.
If you, let me ask you this.
Okay, name me three CCR songs.
Curtis.
Yeah, that one.
Bible. Green River.
Oh, Green River. Go ahead.
Green River is one of them. Credence Clearwater Revival. Credence Clearwater
Revival. I've never
seen
Bobby like this.
I don't know. They're not in the same dimension as the Beatles, though.
All right, can we just move on?
I don't want to move on.
You don't know everything either, so stop making people around you feel bad when they don't know everything about the Beatles. And also, can I just say something?
Like
John Lennon... not that great of a person.
Why?
Oh, you haven't read the article about him yet?
I don't know
yet?
What happened. What did he do?
Tell me
did
why.
He raped someone?
I just read it on Vice.
He raped someone.
No, the reason that he, and I think he admitted to it too, the reason that he preached peace and love all the time was because he was naturally inclined to be this like abusive person. And he apparently.
His mother abandoned him. Just listen to what I'm saying, okay? he wrote the White Album. At that point, you can do whatever you want. And just shut up for a second, okay? And you and I have had this fucking conversation before, mm-hmm. okay? And I'm going to say something, and we might not even be able to air this fucking podcast mm-hmm. about what I'm about to say, okay? But what I'm saying right now is that someone like John Lennon dying isn't the same
we've talked about
as
this.
An Eskimo dying.
Oh, that analogy.
Okay. What I'm saying is that there are just some people in the world, right? They put their footprint. They change cultures with their work, right? They move people. Those people are important. Like if you ever see like a disaster movie, right? And they say, you know what they say? Well, we have this, you know, this shelter or this underground bunker, but we're doing a lottery, but we still have to, you know, scientists and certain doctors and artists, we already pan-picked them. They're already going to come into the thing. Mm-hmm. Why do you think they fucking do that? So retards don't fucking run the world. Right? So it's there are just some people. I'm not saying I'm one of them. I'm a retard. I'm going to be left out of the bunker.
Me too.
The fucking the tsunami is going to get me. Meteor.
I think we're all outside of the bunker.
Yeah, we're out of the bunker. I'm not saying that
except
I'm
for
one
George,
of them.
Maybe.
No, you're, no, he's the first one to die.
But guess who is? Like Trump is safe.
He's like Tia Leone. He's going to be a guy on the beach with his dad,
like
hugging her.
So they watch. They just watch it happen?
And then you just get, that's what you are.
I love Tia Leone.
I do too. But anyway.
What are your thoughts on Brangelina breaking up?
I know Bobby's thoughts. I don't give a fuck.
Yeah, he doesn't give
a
fuck.
No, I do care.
Oh, really?
How dare you? I grew up with them.
Both of them?
Yeah. I grew up with their work.
Both their works?
Yeah.
I didn't die. What do you think about them separating?
Oh, you thought they died.
They were together for a very long time, mm-hmm. all right? They had a bunch of kids together.
So many kids.
Right? Two biological ones, right?
Three.
Three biological ones. They have three real ones.
Kids that are biological.
Listen,
to them.
You know what? I'm going to say something because I'm sick. Adopting, you know, people go, I was adopted. You weren't. I use the other word for that. Abandoned.
Yes.
Yeah.
You know, yeah. I mentioned that before. Okay. It's like, yeah, these people, that's not real though.
What happens when you adopt a child?
I'm not going to adopt one.
What happens? We just do like the situation.
What do you mean what happens? I'm not going to do one.
A baby looks at you. They're like, wow, I wish my father. Oh. You made a connection with the baby. It's looking at you, Bob. It's looking at you. Be my father.
Before Khalyla, I think I matched up with a girl on Tinder, like to go on a date, and she had a baby. And I said no.
Oh, okay.
Why?
Because it's not my baby. I'm cute.
No. That's not why you didn't date her.
Uh-oh.
Why?
You didn't like her enough. Because I think that any man will make concessions for a woman he really loves, kid or no kid. I think if he's really into a woman, it doesn't matter mm-hmm. how many kids she has. That's what it is. You didn't like her enough.
Maybe. But also, it's like, if I'm going to be a father, I just want it to be my genes. You know?
That's just not always how the world works, though, Bobby. You know? Relationships end. Kids get abandoned or orphaned. You know, and sometimes a good man steps into the picture and raises a child that's not their own. And my dad did that, you know.
Shout out to R.
I have an adopted sister.
You're right.
He just flashed before him.
You're right. I'm a failure.
No, you're not.
I am. You're right.
You're just sick.
I'm just sick and I say all kinds of things when I'm not thinking straight.
I might as well kick you while you're down uh-huh. some more.
God. Happy birthday.
Do you guys ever... Does this ever happen to you where all night you have dreams about one person, like a random person, somebody you're not even romantically interested in, someone you've never even considered interesting in the past, but you wake up feeling like you're destined to be with them because you've had this, you dream about them. Mm. Do you ever get that?
Who is it?
you guys don't fucking have dreams about people.
I do, yeah.
The opposite, where if somebody does me wrong in a dream, I'm mad at them for no reason.
Right, so it's exactly like that. So if someone does you wrong in a dream and then you wake up mad at them, like for instance, if I have a dream of him cheating on me, I wake up angry at him. And okay. I'm like, why'd you do that, right?
Who's this guy you're dreaming of?
I'm just saying this. Am I the only one that does, this happens to?
I'll dream.
Where it's like a random, like in the past, I've dreamt about, when I was in a teenager, I dreamt about my swim coach who was this like fat, like lardy, gross fucking dude. And you wake up having the feels for them.
Who is it?
It was some guy, he's married already, but it was some guy who I went to college with. That I never had any like romantic link to, but I woke up this morning feeling like I should find him.
Oh wow.
Okay, I'm crazy. Maybe I'm just crazy. But then the feeling wears off as the day goes on.
So we're still dating, right?
Yeah.
You're my girlfriend, right?
Yes.
You live with me?
Yeah.
And you're having fantasies with fucking some other guy.
It wasn't a fuck fantasy. You know what we did? We laid in bed and stared into each other's eyes.
That is even worse than that. What is his name?
Trevor.
His name is Trevor, you swear to God.
Yeah.
Trevor, if you're listening right now. Trevor, if you're listening right now.
Uh-oh.
If you even contact my girlfriend or text her, I don't give a fuck.
I don't give a fuck.
And you do any kind of winky wink, you know. Sly shit, I'll get you. And I'm gonna say this too, Trevor. People think that I don't know people. People look at me and they go, "Oh, Bob, he's just a comedian." I know fucking people, dude. I know people from the underworld, bro. You know, I know dudes that will do things to
you. Kate Beckinsale.
Okay,
ooh, good movie.
Not that underworld.
Oh.
Okay. And so you know, you laugh in my face, you ridicule me, right? Remember this. My fucking phone list goes deeper than just haha people. I know David Spade.
He knows aliens.
Okay. I know David Spade.
David Spade.
You know, really, you had that fantasy. I don't care. You want to leave me?
I don't. I'm just.
You haven't dreamt about like another woman?
I'm certain I'm not the only one who ever feels this way. This happens at least like 3-4 times a year when I'm like, why the fuck do I feel
because
this
way? It's like this. It's like when I want to use drugs, mm-hmm. I'm a recovering drug addict and alcoholic, right? You think it through, okay? So when you go, I go, God, I wish I could smoke some pot. All right, think it through. You smoke pot, what happens the next day? You probably don't want to smoke more pot. You know what I mean? And you think it through. And then at 6 months through in your head, the end is always inevitably bad or awful or nightmarish. Okay? Same with women. Yeah, I might look at a girl, wow, she's really attractive. Mm-hmm. But the same, and then what happens? Okay? It's always a nightmarish impossibility bad thing.
Or not.
No, it is. Because the thing is this. I am one of those that believe that you and I are not seeing each other through random chance. That there is a cosmic universe that brought us together. Because I believe that I would not have a podcast if it wasn't for you. I believe that there are certain things that I wouldn't have gotten in my career if it wasn't for you. Because you forced me into doing auditions that I don't want to do. Like fucking Problem Child. I didn't want to go in for Problem Child. And she goes... We fought in the middle of the street, and she's like, go in. And I went in, and I got it. I mean, didn't get picked up,
but
I did the pilot, and I got paid really good money, okay? So my point is that I feel like we're all here in some sort of, like, there's some sort of cosmic glue keeping us together. So I don't think that way. If you think that it's not that, then get out of the relationship.
I'm not threatening to leave you, bro.
Yeah, you're having fucking fantasy fuckhole dreams about other people.
No, Trevor, but
Trevor. Trevor.
That's superficial, and it belongs in the REM part of my life.
Yeah, I don't have dreams like that.
You don't have dreams because you're depressed.
So you sleep, and then you remember closing your eyes, you wake up, and it's a new day?
Kind of like that.
Whoa.
It's so I sleep, weird to me.
And then I hear, well, I mean, lately I hear a dog bark, and then I hear like Goonie trying to get either in or out of the room, but I ignore it. It's my cat.
Yeah.
And then I do this with my mouth.
Yeah, you eat. Lot. She said you eat.
Yeah, and then I wake up and I feel groggy. Like, oh, life. And then I immediately think, what today? Nothing.
I'm certain that you dream. You just don't remember any of them when you get up.
Sometimes I do.
Oh, you do? What was the last one?
So you do dream.
I mean, I have reoccurring dreams that I've had since I've been a kid.
Mm-hmm. Oh, you have same dreams.
Oh, yeah.
Oh, I've never had that.
I have a really good, cool ones. I have one reoccurring. I'll hear one of my reoccurring dreams.
Yeah.
That I, so I'm on a plane, okay, and it gets shipwrecked on an island, okay? I'm the only one alive. And there's no food. Like, there's, it's like an island that's uninhabited. There's no boars or anything. But what they do have on the island, right, thousands of years ago, a meteor crashed in it. And it's got this like reddish pink glow to it, this meteor. And it kind of calls me. It's in the center of the island. So I just kind of go, why am I going toward the center there? I'm hungry. I should figure out. But there's something that I gravitate toward it. Mm-hmm. And I get to it, and an energy out of the meteor comes into my body, right? And all of a sudden, my mind, my brain, you know how we only certain percentage of our brain we use.
Mm-hmm.
It opens up all the channels in my brain and
portals.
Also makes me
like limitless.
Yeah. Limitless, and also makes me kind of I'm psychic, and also I can fly. I'm like a superhero.
Yeah, right? It's basically the Superman origin story.
Yeah, but no, it's not. It's not that. Because I do things. Because then what happens is that because now I have a prophecy. I also the reason why the meteor is there is because it's a meteor, right, that there's galaxies and there's all these alien races and war and this and that. Mm-hmm. That was the one little, there's something in there, a particle in there that they are all looking for, and I got it. And it's in me forever, right? And I can also see the future. And what I see is 1,000 years from now that there's going to be a gigantic takeover from aliens to Earth. So everything that I do now is to prepare for 1,000 years from now, aliens are going to take over.
Okay.
I'm not done.
Okay.
So here's what I do. Number one, I don't want people to know that I have the power.
So secret.
I do is I make a fucking a raft out of wood and stuff, and then I fly to the middle of the ocean, and I just plop on it, and I wait for like a cargo ship to pick me up. So I want people to think that I made this raft.
Yeah.
Then they take me.
They were rescued.
Yeah, rescued. Yeah. I go to Hawaii, right? And then you and Steve and everyone comes and sees it. People cry. My parents are still alive. They cry. Welcome back. But what I start doing is that because I'm psychic and stuff like that, I go to Vegas and I make a lot of money. Mm. Yeah, because I need money.
Wait,
because but they can't even get you because you're not counting cards. You just have superpowers.
Yeah, I have superpowers, right? I just make a whole lot of money through gambling.
Mm.
And then I make an underground scientific bunker where I create, number one, I can create a thing that makes other people live forever. Number two, I'm making androids too. Okay.
Mm-hmm.
I'm doing a lot of things to like prepare for this thing from 1,000 years from now.
All coming from a guy who says he doesn't dream.
That's an awesome dream.
No, because it's not really a dream. It's like I dreamt it, but that's also in my head right when I go to sleep, I think about it.
It's the same story you think about every
day.
Yeah,
I think about like five stories. They're all kind of in depth like that.
Yeah.
That's one of them. But anyway, it just keeps going like that.
Why do you think of that? Like, what is the parallels to this reality?
I don't know.
Shit.
I have a soccer one too. I'll share next.
I know that soccer one. Yeah, you told me about that.
Play
one.
For a huge team.
No, but it's even weirder than that. That I'm from like a family like my sister's Lucy Liu.
Wait, what?
My
brother.
Yes.
Awesome.
My mom and my dad are in show
business.
My mom and dad, my dad's a huge director, right?
Yeah.
And my mom is like, she's like a costume designer, but they're also Korean. They have like accents, right? And they have four kids, right? The oldest kid is like a huge director. My sister, second, right, is a actress like Lucy Liu.
Mm-hmm.
The third one is like David Cho, who's like an artist, a kind of a deadbeat, but really talented. Mm-hmm. And the fourth one is a soccer player, me.
Wow.
Right. And so my parents were so busy that my uncle, right, he was into soccer and he babysat me. So I, as a kid, learned. Mm-hmm. Like, I fell in love with it, mm-hmm. right? And I'm double-footed, right? And then it goes really in-depth. And then I try out for a team in L.A., right? I'm a prodigy. Then here's what happens, though. I get into the under-16s USA national soccer team. I qualify us for the World Cup.
Mm-hmm.
And then they don't bring me to the World Cup.
Why?
It's a weird turn.
Because I'm a recluse. I don't listen to the coach.
You're not coachable.
I'm not coachable because I'm so good.
You're the trouble.
Right.
Troubled star.
So then this is what happens, right? In the dream, right? So then I get lost and I'm like 15, 16 years old. I'm fucking sad. And then the Red Bulls, New York Red Bulls, they call me up there just to, because they know that I'm talented and to see. And Thierry Henry sees me.
Thierry Henry, yeah.
Because Henry used to play for the Red Bulls. And then what happens in the thing is that now the Red Bulls are trying to sign me. Right? But Thierry Henry does like a backroom thing with Arsene Wenger. Come check this kid out.
Yeah.
I signed with Arsenal. Right.
What the fuck?
Right. It gets even crazier. It goes crazier.
Are
right?
you your 5'3" self?
No.
Oh, so you're a different.
What do you look
I'm
6'1".
Like?
Oh, you're 6'1".
Yeah, yeah, I'm good looking too.
Wow.
Yeah, okay. I have long hair. I'm like weird.
I want to date
but
him.
But also, but my.
Go ahead.
But also in the thing is that I'm really kind of like, Bellatelli, where like, I do weird
unpredictable.
Shit. I do weird shit in interviews. Yeah. I'll like hug the guy for a very long time.
Yeah. Like a jackass.
Yeah. Type. No. Yeah. Yeah. Sometimes I'll just do gibberish. You know, like I'm really crazy, right? But this is what happens: is that the Arsenal fans are mad that they fucking bought me because I'm an American, right? So you know, I think I'm going to be traded, whatnot. But we start having injuries, and then Drew gets injured in my fantasy.
And you're third string.
I'm like ninth string.
Oh.
Like
okay.
And then one day we're playing at home against Tottenham. Mm-hmm. And Tottenham's beating us 3-0. And we have no more strikers. They're all hurt. And so they sub me in, right?
And I
score 4 goals.
Oh, wow. Wow.
Yeah, so it goes crazy.
I feel like I'm really living it. Yeah, like, I'm really happy right now.
I'm like watching this.
Yeah, yeah, yeah. I have all these little fantasies in my head that I do when I go to sleep.
Someone please animate that last one.
I have so many of them. I really do. I have so many good ones in my head that I've done for years. There's like 5 or 6 of them anyway. Yeah.
Wow.
Yeah.
Question?
But here's another thing. I'm not done yet. Okay. I'm not done with. Here's another thing, though. In the right. See, my sister's way older than me, right? So George Clooney used to date my sister.
She's a famous Asian.
Yeah. Right. Sister. No, but George Clooney, right? Comes. I just had these fantasies that George Clooney comes to the Arsenal matches because I don't want all the Arsenal players. I want them all to think that I'm weird.
Yeah.
But then I have all these celebrities because my parents grew up in Hollywood.
Yeah. You have connects.
That like just people come out, you know what I mean? To see me like Obama comes.
Whoa.
You know what I mean? Just
after presidency though.
Where, yeah, after
like
president.
He's ex-president
at
this point.
So it's like, and then like, but I'm also don't talk to anybody. I'm really shy, right? And also I'm an artist too, just like my brother, like the David Joe character. And I don't date girls. I'm asexual. Whoa. So I just paint. I wear like, you know, like I'll go to coffee shops near Emirates Stadium, right? Wearing like a sombrero, you know what I mean? A poncho. And like flippers, like I'm just really eccentric. Well, people were just right about me. This guy's so fucking crazy, but I'm better than Messi. So anyway, question.
Speaking of asexuality.
Yeah.
That's actually like a legit thing, right? When someone is asexual, they have no desire in their loins. Yeah, they have no desire in their loins to actually perform any type of like coitus or feel any type of like physical, like sexual pleasure. When I was younger I used to not believe it. Like, how can you not want to at least like perform sex? But these people still want to date. They want to hold. They want the bonding, like emotional, like connection, but just want nothing to do with the loins.
Yeah,
it's not. And they can have like lifelong relationships. Yeah.
This guy Trevor, you're not gonna leave me for him.
I'm not leaving you.
And I just remember, I love you so much, so don't leave.
I'm not. Oh my God, are you kidding me? You're the ninth string player from Arsenal who just scored 4 goals.
Know, everyone gets injured.
Thank you.
I'm dating you. Yeah. We're together. That is so attractive.
And George, I really thank you for being in my life. I really, you know what? When I met you at Maker long ago, I knew deep down inside this was going to happen. And you, Gilbert, fucking read a book. Do something.
All right.
Okay.
Yeah, man. I'm sorry.
Grow.
I'm sorry.
All right. And the Platters are not like the Beatles.
Yeah, but
they're not. But you should know.
Their songs are well
songs.
Covered. Their songs are well covered. I'm like,
I'm also gonna throw the fucking slipper at your fucking face.
Okay. But, oh, Georgia slip.
No, these are mine. Go ahead. Give me the
unhelpful advice with Bobby at Khalyla. This is from our friend Thomas. Hey guys, I'm a 17-year-old guy from a small town in Maryland, and I am a 4th Filipino. My grandfather was the only person I knew who was from the Philippines. He passed away a few years ago, and I'm trying to find the Filipino man inside of me. I live in a really white area where there is no culture at all. I have no clue how to tap into that great culture without my grandpa, and I don't want to just Google facts. How do I find myself or my family's culture in a white man society? Thank you very much. Keep doing what you're doing. Thomas.
Where does he live? I mean, I need to know that.
I don't know, just rural white area. He doesn't have a place.
A rural white area. I mean,
Maryland. Maryland.
How old is he? 17. He's 17. Well, I mean, you're young. I mean, I grew up in a white area also, and I didn't have really. I mean, there was only one Asian dude that went to my school that I remembered even knowing, you know. And then, and I didn't know any. And it's like when you leave and you go out into the world, you will find your people. You will find, you know what I mean, your culture. As soon as I came to LA, it was just a great eye-opener for me. I went to the spas. I went to Korean restaurants. I met other Koreans that were like-minded, like David Cho, mm-hmm. people like that. And you will find your people. And I now am so blessed that I am Korean. I'm so proud of that fact. I don't want to be anybody else. I love being fat and weird and walking into situations and have people go, who the fuck is that weird dude? I like that. And this Filipino guy, you're too young, but when you go out into the world, you will find your people. You will. And also just say it. Open your mind up and it'll come to you. You'll manifest it. Your people will be drawn to you.
So does this kid not feel like he's connected to being Filipino?
Yeah, he wants to learn more about himself, his culture.
And I, well, you know what? This is funny that I think that you could probably speak on this, Gilbert. Mm-hmm. You're a Filipino guy.
I have my whole family, though. He has no one.
So. You do, but even when I first met mm-hmm. you.
Oh, yeah.
You know, there were a lot of things that I felt you said that mm-hmm. you felt like disconnected mm-hmm. to. Like not knowing how Filipinos like legit are in like the Philippines, right? Because it's a very big difference. Filipino Americans, the Filipinos that grow up there. There is a huge difference.
Yeah. I just thought of something.
What? What did you think
say
of?
About the Philippines?
Nothing. But I have another suggestion for the guy. Right?
Yeah, go ahead.
If he has a bathtub, then what you do is you fill the bathtub up. Just listen, okay? With water, right?
Mud.
And then put in 60 pounds of human shit.
There it goes.
Right?
There it goes.
And mud.
There it is.
And you mix it and just lay in there and just go, you know what I mean? I'm in the Philippines.
There it is. The mud river. We knew he was going to bring it up, Khalyla. We knew it. But we were prepared.
I mean...
We knew it.
At this point, I feel like Filipinos are going to be angry at me.
I don't know why I say that. I don't know why I say something like that.
They're going to be angry at me for dating him.
Yeah, yeah. And put like a duck egg in the middle of it, and then you're in. You know what I mean?
A balut egg.
Yeah, yeah. No, I mean.
Can I finish your thought, though, for this kid?
Yeah, he's 17. I think that you're probably on the right track if you're aware of how little... you know about the culture, at least you're aware of that. That's the first step to knowing everything is knowing is accepting that you know nothing.
Can I just say this? I feel bad for saying that.
Say.
And I want to say, listen, I want to say something about Koreans. I know that in Korea, there's a fucking illegal dog, you know, trading going on there.
We have it in the Philippines.
Yeah, they have a dog meat trade industry there. And I just disgusted the fact that we do that. I love my animals.
You guys don't have an excuse because you're a first world country. In the Philippines, it's like, yeah, we eat dog and we do this because we're fucking poor, right?
They're just thirsty things.
We live in a life of vice. But you guys, what the fuck is your problem? You're a rich country. Get it together.
I know. So what I don't think.
I'd rather be a fucking mud swimmer.
Well, you know what now? Now I want to say what I really feel.
Oh my God.
Is that you guys aren't even a country.
Oh, we're not.
It's a shit. It's a piece of shit floating in the ocean, and there's people on it. Fucking dare you! I try to fucking.
It's so funny how he's so protective. He's so protective of his motherland, Korea, but he was completely treated like shit when he actually went there because he doesn't speak Korean well. Your own people rejected you, bro.
Boom. Mic drop. Khalyla can do it because he's not here to defend himself.
Yeah. Oh, God. I have to pee so bad.
Thank you guys for listening to TigerBelly.
God, how long was that and how much do we have to edit? Dear God.
We're good. We don't have to edit anything.
Hey, so listen, guys. If you haven't already checked out our most recent Instagram post, we announced that we are having a little celebration, a small one, with a handful of you guys that we are going to choose sometime this week. We are going to record a live podcast next Tuesday at 9 p.m. Those of you that get chosen will join us and sit with us and sit through an hour of Bobby and I just talking. We'll do a meet and greet and just have fun. If you haven't already checked out the Instagram post and if you want to be considered for it, email us. Tell us a little bit about yourself. Tell us how you discovered the podcast. And
make sure you put in the subject line birthday.
Oh yes, and
so we know.
On the email subject line is birthday, so we can get back to you sometime this week.
Yeah, and shout out to some of you guys with some great emails.
Right, we've probably, I mean, my God, the amount of emails and the amount of time you guys have actually taken to write the emails has been so, like, warms my heart.
I'm glad we have great people that are listeners.
Amazing. I mean, all four of us have read every single one of your emails. And even if you don't get chosen, trust me.
All four of us.
The sheer fact that you've written in.
All four of us.
Yeah.
Or three of us.
No, I read them all to Bobby.
Oh, you read them.
On our way to Brea, I read all of them to him. And he was getting teary-eyed.
Yes.
It really, really made him feel good. Yeah, because we just started this 11 months ago. And it, you know, we get a lot of naysayers and a lot of negativity. But, you know, when the positive ones roll through.
They rise to the top.
It's the greatest feeling in the world. Yeah, so many nice. It really is. And I can't tell you how many times I cried this weekend just reading those emails. Like, I want to cry right now. It's touching. It makes me feel like, holy fuck, you know, this
people
is
like
something.
You do, yeah.
Yeah. This is something special. And I think that we're going to have a good time on Tuesday, and I can't wait to meet some of you guys. Mm-hmm. And
also piggybacking off that, thank you guys for that thing. I was asking you guys to try to get to 500 subscribers on iTunes. We're really close. Reviews. We have more subscribers than that.
Imagine if you only had 500. Come on.
Thanks for getting us to 40 subscribers. We're so excited for all 40 of you. No, we're at like 420 reviews. We're almost at 500. Share it with your friends, please. And if you haven't left us a review yet on iTunes, even though if you're a SoundCloud listener or a listener somewhere else on YouTube, go over to iTunes and leave us a review. Anything else? Shows for Bobby, Khalyla?
Bobby is going to be at Levity Live in Oxnard, California. Oh, no, before this. This weekend, he will be doing Oddball Comedy Festival in Houston, Dallas, and Austin, September, I think that's whatever Thursday, Friday, Saturday of this week is.
Whatever
and next weekend, he's going to be at Levity Live in Oxnard, California. And then after that, sometime in October, he will be doing Punchline in San Francisco.
Will you be at Oxnard and San Francisco?
I will be at Oxnard. I think we all should be in Oxnard. We should make a weekend of it.
Well, I'll be in New York. Find me there.
And, oh, Gilbert's not going to be there. And, yeah, I love San Francisco still, even though I have my gripes.
Your gripes.
But, yeah, I'm probably going to be there just to get away. But, yep, I think that's all we have for this week.
Yeah. Just so you guys know, if you guys are sending packages to us, we are getting them. And Bobby and Khalyla, George, myself, we love them. So I don't think people don't know if they're getting here, but they are getting here. We do have video of them. We'll release a vlog one day. We'll vlog some of the opening package, but thank you for all the packages and things.
Yeah,
you guys
thank
sent.
You. Trey sent me this hat last week.
Shout out to Trey. We always get this. Some person from Thailand keeps sending us like Lay's with different flavors.
Oh, I think that's Roxy.
That's Roxy.
Yeah,
shout out to Roxy.
She's our patron, yeah.
Yes, follow us on TigerBelly at TigerBelly. Follow us on Twitter at TheTigerBelly. If you want to email any questions, please keep sending us questions at thetigerbelly@gmail.com. You can follow Khalyla on social media at
Calamity K.
All across the board, you can follow George at Voted Best Tweets or George Kimmel. Or just look him up on LinkedIn. Friend him there. Also, if you still have the George Kimmel internship program, if you want to be involved with George, learn the business behind the scenes, you can email at thetigerbelly@gmail.com with the subject line, George Kimmel internship program, # George has a pink dick. And you can follow me at Gilbert. Have a good night. Bye.
Thanks, you guys, for listening. We'll see you next week. Ciao. Kalau dapat kami lebih buruk kaya kapak itu lukma syukur lukma lah ye suku juga kumur pakai cukup bola kalau dapat